guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I have a very exciting video for you. I'm going to be reading the first chapter of my book, Fervent Lust, Faux Serpent, now available on Amazon and Barnes & Nobles, and you are going to experience the darkest, edgiest mafia romance that has ever been written by an Asian author. Are you excited? This is the new batch of paperbacks that I ordered from Amazon, and so far they look pretty good compared to the last batch that I ranted on. Still has that glossy, annoying glossy patches, as you can see, but this batch they did a lot better to minimize that kind of error. Let's get started with the first chapter, shall we? Okay, here's the title page. Copyright, table of contents, a little intro. Do I like him burning plain? As sudden as Cupid, as bad as fiend. Should I want him firing sky? Shoots out doubt like New Year's alive. Shall I friend him raging wind? Blows on the wound he keeps me in. Must I choose him mocking sun? Lights up my sig, for my peace is done. Need I leave him brooding night? Cradles me never, for forever means imminent goodbye. Chapter 1. Initiation. 489 Snakehead adds up to resurrection. March times July death, same carrot on the diamond. Double agent liaison. 21K. This dark rainy sky looked like any other dawn, except it wasn't. The clouds drifted above the periwinkle glow, lurking in the distant horizon. The red taxicab bombarded with bullets of water as we splashed through the flooded streets, and I couldn't be any more stiff by the window, tilting in deep contemplation. The sprawling array of neon signs blinking down the airy road added a nostalgic ambience under the heavy monsoon. The glistening city lights painted a sinister rainbow on my doleful face with uncertainty. How long till we get there? I asked the old driver.
About 20 minutes, miss, he said, tired.
I'm in kind of a hurry. Can you please make it 10? I rushed him before my mind changed and brought me back home. I need to be there at 5 o'clock sharp.
Okay, I'll try. But it's not even open at that time yet, miss.
I'm meeting a few people there, I averted his curiosity. The windshield wipers went berserk as we passed Wongkok, popular for its red light district, an inch through Yeomate, famous for its street markets. When Tin Hau Temple and Victoria Harbor were in my radar, I knew we were getting close. Then I panicked. My heart squeezed inside my chest. My stomach twisted in knots. My breath competed with the speed of the battering raindrops, and I was winning. What atrocity had I gotten myself into? Must this be the life fate destined me to choose? More importantly, was I ready to die for it?
We're here, miss. Fukluxiao, Timsatui. He came to a halt. Asian Garden of Fortune, known as Fukluxiao, was the headquarters of the biggest triad in Hong Kong, 21K. Aside from the shady business, the giant three-story building was a shopping mall specializing in cheap gold and jewelry. From secondhand to handmade, fake to 24K, cubic zirconia to high-grade diamond, this was the place to haggle for sparkles. If diamond was made from pressure, then my heart must be twinkling right now.
Thank you, I paid him and opened the door. Hesitantly, I took a deep breath before walking out in the pouring rain, my jacket hood up, my cold hands well hidden in my pockets. I zoomed to the back of the building through the empty parking lot, until a suspicious security guard put out his hand.
Who are you? He squinted, his tone unpleasant.
I slipped out the half-folded red envelope in my left pocket and showed him.
I'm Ginger. I'm with 40 Ga.
He didn't even check and unlock the glass door to let me inside. As soon as under shelter, I shook off the wet debris and dreaded my way toward what felt like purgatory. The place was a ghost town. Every store was closed, with its rusty shutters full of ads and graffiti, but the lights were brightly lit as if opening was near.
The instruction in the envelope directed me to the main court of the mall, where the next summon was. Turnhead is the shore, 42F. I shuddered. The clue sat by the bowl of fig fruits and floral offerings in front of three Gali statues that presided over the central stage, Fook, Fortune, Luke, Prosperity, and so, Longevity. A famous Buddhist proverb meant to teach a lesson of remorse and forgiveness. For a second, I thought it was an omen to get the fuck out of here before it was too late, but I let it slide. Not a sign. It's just a coincidence, I kept chanting to my twitchy left eye. If I gave up now, I could never bring my diamond-shaped face back to shore, the laughingstock of a former go-go dancer who wanted to play with the big boys but chickened out at the last minute. Wasn't going to be my legacy. I didn't know what was going to happen after I stepped behind that door, but I knew my life would change forever. Suddenly, a rush of adrenaline burned through me like a dragon raging the sky, and I burst it open with one fiery kick of passion. Who the fuck did that? A thug, smoking his cigarette, popped out from the end of the narrow corridor, scolding me.
Sorry, Daigo. I couldn't get it to open. Must be old.
I trembled with a coy smile, gently closing the door behind me, and ran up to him.
Hurry up! You're late. Everyone's already started. He scowled as I walked with him into the haunting, candle-lit red room.
The forbidden ground was separated into three parts, the sword arch, the grand table, and the crimson altar, while the strong, floral incense and burning joysticks filled the hazy atmosphere with menace. As expected, all the leaders in 21K were here, hosting the ceremony, the incense master, 438, Tiger, a geezer, with a receding hairline and a gap smile. Next to him, the Vanguard, 438, 40, who survived more slashes in a gang fight at 19 than all his foot soldiers combined. Together, they performed the initiation ritual for new members, and I, among some hoodlum wannabes in front of me, was a viable candidate.
Ginger, take off your clothes and come here, 40 commanded, motioned me to move forward, holding a white rope at the end of the first obstacle.
The stern thugs promptly raised their swords, pointing toward each other from both sides. A daunting tunnel was created. On the ground, a path of hot embers, smoldering like orange fireflies, awaited. My nerves vomited itself back down my nauseous throat. I slid off my heels, timidly shredded to bare porcelain, and commenced. My left foot took the first step.
Ah! I groaned quietly. After the right foot joined, I felt the fire burning hotter through my thin soul with each wobble. Steam sizzled through the cracks of the crooked charcoals.
Ooh, ow! I hastily skipped the last few steps, finished with a stumble, and kneeled my naked bum in front of 40.
Good, Ginger. Now put this on, 40 ordered, with a proud smile, and handed me a white robe.
I wrapped it around my petite body, sweating and suffocating in this high humidity, the fear of the unknown. But all mistakes progress with consequences, and I was dealing with mine. 40 led me to the big red altar past the grand table, where I kneeled with five other new members, my sworn brothers, in front of Guan Yiga, a fierce deity of loyalty and integrity. As Tiger recited some ancient Chinese poetries, 40 prepared the reptilian offering to the ancestors, blood for the dead, bile for the soon-to-be, and it was the vilest shot of agony. We each held three burning joysticks with our right hand overlapping our left. At their cue, we fully bowed seven times before sticking them in the central gold pot. Behind it, a whole roasted pig staring right at me. Its lifeless eyes mocked what I'd become if this ended badly, and the fact that I was born in the year of a pig didn't boost my confidence either.
Another unlucky omen. If a third one appeared before this ceremony deceased, I was so fucking out of here.
While 40 and Tiger performed a traditional Chinese anthem and the 36 oaths from the original triad philosophy, I wasn't listening. The detailed code implicated how each member should conduct themselves and treat their fellow members, but I couldn't care less. Indeed, I was distracted by someone else. Sitting in the center seat at the grand table must be the Dragonhead 489, Wolfgang. I'd never met or seen him before, but I recognized his place at the chair, the fedora hiding his grayish black locks, and the dark peacoat gave it away, since I heard Forty said our leader was a big fan of Chow Yun-fat. Next to him on the right side, the Mountain Master, 438-60, a scrawny old mobster who raked in the most money for 21K, drug trafficking, loan sharking, illegal gambling, etc. His six figures loot every week earned him that moniker as Wolfgang's trusty personnel. Then came the Red Pole, 426 Santa, a beer-bellied, long-bearded uncle who looked like he might need to take his insulin soon. His orchestration, tariff collection, extortion, and gang violence. On the left side of the table was another Red Pole, 426, Scarface, a fake blonde hooligan who assisted Santa with his enforcement before a different region on Hong Kong Island. I recalled meeting him at Forty's Club Insomniac one night when he asked for a lap dance from my friend Minnie. A big muscular potato he was, with the face of a mad dog ready to maul his enemy into pieces. The reddish-brown birthmarks on the left side of his face would scare anyone into submission. And lastly, him, the boy with the face tattoo. The one who hadn't paid any attention to me or anything else happening around him. The black face mask, which he always wore, defined his permanent leering eyes. The intense dark energy surrounding his mysterious aura disturbed me to keep my guard up, inevitably. The way his long silky hair framed his perfectly sharp jawline while stroking his baby cheeks had me curious. The tingly sensation inside my chest as I sneaked peeks at him drove me insane. The white paper fan, 415, 21K's bookkeeper and lead strategist, Mr. E, known as Mystery. On the left side of his hidden scowl, a fierce tiger stalked from temple to cheek in bluish-black ink, marking how silent but deadly he is, and that was why I could never forget it. What he did to me, no matter how hard I tried. Ginger, what's 25 stands for? 40 suddenly quizzed me in the middle of my naughty daydream. I don't know, Daigo, I stumped, still kneeling. Ginger, la, 40 sighed with a grimace. The embarrassment shrank me to the shameful floor as I pouted. Oath number 25, I'll never share or reveal any secrets or signs to anyone else but my brothers, Daigo, the guy next to me answered. Wrong, another initiated member argued. If I decided to deny my membership or fail to fulfill my duties to my brotherhood, then I'll get killed by a myriad of swords. Wrong, Tiger berated him. If I'm arrested, I'm not to rat out or put blame on my brothers and must accept my punishment. Otherwise, I'll be killed by five thunderbolts. The last guy took a shot at the riddle. Wrong, 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 you're all wrong, Tiger scolded us like an angry parent. This is the most important one, Forty stressed. His hawk eyes watched us shiver. 25 is the undercover fucker, I gulped. My back broke in icy sweats. The rest of my breathing froze for the ending that was near, the death of me. This is a traitor, Tiger jabbed his meat cleaver at the roasted pig on the altar. What's the punishment for someone who betrays his brothers? His face lurched toward mine, glaring with only inches apart. Without blinking, my eyes shot up at him.